Yes, Pastor One, and welcome to our sixth Egyptian goddess, Nut. She is known as the Barrel of the Gods. Anyhow, here's her titles, alternate names and spellings, hieroglyphics, and what she is goddess of. Enjoy. Welcome back, everyone, to Goddess Nut. Now, Nut is known as Barrel of the Gods. There are some stories here, first of all, that Ra knew that his throne was going to be, you know, taken over by one of Nut's children if she ever got pregnant. And so he declared that she'd be separated from her husband, Geb. And henceforth, he sent Shu, Geb's and Nut's father, to separate her from him, dividing the earth, the heavens, basically, between, Nut is always outstretched in four points, you know, stretched, and Geb's underneath her all the time. So, that represents the four corners. So there's where we get our four corners from, you know, when we call the corners. And then we have, like, she's like, then how did she ever have children? Well, before this, she wanted to bear children. Ra knew that she was pregnant somehow. So he separated her from ever giving birth by saying, you should never give birth on any of the days of the week. So, she went to Thoth and asked him to challenge the moon god. Can't think of his name right now, guys. I'm so sorry. But anyhow, Thoth challenged the moon god and awarded the four extra days of the year. And got enough wins that to give him a little bit of his light every time he lost. So, he won enough to give actually 4 days, extra days to calendar. Back then, the calendar was not that of how many days it is now. So, with those 4 extra days, she gave birth to 4 children, which we know them as Osiris, Seth, Nephthys, and Isis. Henceforth, Isis bore Horus, which did take over for Ra. So anyhow, this is it for Goddess Nut. I hope you enjoyed this presentation, and God bless.